Welcome back to one more video session. This is Vasant Naik from Canara Engineering College. In this video, you are going to study data flow model of ARM7 TDMI based processor, or it is also called as core architecture of ARM7. So here you can see the architecture of ARM7. I am going to explain you what is data bus, what is address bus, what is register file, what is ALU, what is MAC, what is instruction decoder, etc. one by one. Let's start the video. Now, this is the architecture of ARM7. So, in my previous video, I have told you ARM is based on the register. ARM makes use of so many registers, like around 37 registers are used by ARM7. Out of that, at any time, 16 registers are visible, that is R0 to R15. Now, students, you know, what is the job of any processor? The job of any processor is, first one is, it has to fetch the instruction. Second one, it has to decode the instruction. Third one, it has to execute the instruction. This is the job of any processor. For fetching instruction, the first, it has to locate the address. To locate the address of the next instruction will be given by program counter. We know the job of the program counter is, program counter will give the address of the next instruction has to be executed. So, in ARM7, register R15 acts like a program counter. That means register R15 will give the address of the next instruction has to be executed. So that address is placed on the address bus. And the address is decoded, and the instruction from that location will be moved to the processor through data bus. Here you can see, the instruction will be moved to the processor through data bus. Now the instruction contains both data as well as instruction. And this instruction will be moved to the processor through data bus. Suppose instruction contains instruction, then instruction will be moved to the instruction decoder. If it contains data, then it will be moved to the sign extend. That we will see later. If the instruction contains instruction, then it will be moved to the decoder. What is the job of the decoder? The job of the decoder is to analyze the instruction. Normally, when you write the program, in assembly language ADAX, BX. Something like this. But inside the computer, the instructions are stored in the form of ones and zero, that is binaries. And that is called as opcode. So the main job of the decoder is to decode the opcode or analyze the opcode. There will be separate opcode for separate instruction. Like separate opcode for each instruction. For example, add AX, BX contains one opcode. If you use like add subtract AX, BX, that contains one more opcode. So the main job of the instruction decoder is to analyze the opcode, and it has to tell the other unit what action has to be taken based on that. In ARM7, as I told in my previous video, which makes use of hardwire execution unit for the decoding purpose. The advantage of the hardwire execution unit is which will execute the instruction in one, which will decode the instruction in one clock cycle, compared to a micro programmed control unit which is used by most of the CISC processor. So instruction decoder makes use of hardwire execution unit which executes the instruction in one clock cycle. Which will decode the instruction. Based on the decoding, it will send the signal to the various various units of the architecture, what action has to be executed. ought action has to be executed. So that is the job of the instruction decoder. Now we'll move to the sign extend part of this one. As I said, if the data contains instruction, instruction will move to the instruction decoder. If the data contains data, then data will be moved to the sign extend. We know ARM7 contains 37 registers. Out of that, R0 to R15, 16 registers of 32-bit size available at any time. If the data is 32-bit, directly data will be moved to the register. Now, what if the data is 8-bit or 16-bit? I told you in my previous video, ARM7 supports 8-bit data, 16-bit data, and 32-bit data. 8-bit data is called as a byte, 16-bit data is called as half word, and 32-bit data is called as word. So now the question comes, if it is a 32-bit data, then data will be moved directly into the register file and stored in the register file. What about if the 8-bit data and 16-bit data? If the 8-bit data or 16-bit data, then data will be moved into the sign extend. Sign extend. What is the purpose of the sign extend now? The question comes, what is the purpose of the sign extend? For example, take the data is 25. If the data is 25, then the sign extend will extend this one and it will store something like this in 32-bit format. That means it will extend the data either by zeros or ones. Now the question comes, can extending means just, is it just adding zeros or ones? It is not exactly like that. Extending means adding zeros or ones based on the sign bit. So let's we'll see this one by taking one example. So we'll take 5. 5 can be written as +5 or -5. So the +5 can be write like 101 in 4-bit format. -5, you know, -5 can be written in 2's complement. So to convert this one 5 into 2's complement, let me take 2's complement 1 1 0 1. This is the value in 2's complement. Suppose if you want to write this in 8-bit value, then you need to extend remaining 4-bit like this. And here, in case of -5, you need to extend remaining 4-bit like this. That means extender will extend the value based on the sign bit. If the sign bit is 0, then it will extend the data by adding 0. If the sign bit is 1, it will extend the data by adding 1. That is the job of extender. So extender, sign extender will add either 0 or 1 based on the sign bit. So students, sign extender is the function which extend the number based on this sign bit, hence the name sign extender. And one more thing you have to remember here, sign extender is provided for loading the number, not storing the number. See, if you think like here it is the memory, if you assume this is the memory, then we know with respect to ARM, two operation will be carried out with respect to memory. One is store and other one is load. For load operation, there is a sign extend. For store operation, there is no sign extend. This is because, you know, when you store any number, when you store any value from the register, it is automatically a 32-bit. No need to extend once again. But when you load the number from the memory, then the number may be 8 bit or 16 bit or 32 bit. If it is 32 bit, then the number will be directly loaded into the register. If it is 8 bit and if it is a 16 bit, the number needs to be sign extended based on the sign bit. So the number needed to be extended based on the sign bit, either 0 or 1. So this is called as sign extend. Now student, we'll move to the internal architecture like ALU and other functional unit. So you can see here the internal architecture like this ALU and barrel shifter and all these units where the arithmetic and logic processing take place. It is completely isolated from memory. That means it neither take any value from the memory or it will give any value to the memory. It will work only on the register. That is, it will take value from the register, it will do the computation, either arithmetic operation or logic operation, and it will pass the result to the register. So we have R0 to R15, 16 registers at a time. So now how this works exactly, what type of operations are performed by ALU? ALU will perform arithmetic operation. Second one is logical operations and arithmetic operations. So it will perform arithmetic and logical operations. Now, before explaining this one, let me explain one more thing here. ARM supports triadic instructions. ARM supports triadic instruction. What do you mean by triadic instruction? Triadic instruction is something like suppose if I write add R0, R1, R2. What is the meaning of this one? The meaning of this one is that you are not adding R0 plus R1 plus R2. It is not like that. You are going to add here R1 plus R2 and you are going to store the result in R0. This is called triadic. What is the use of this one? Suppose if you instead of this one, if you use the instruction like add R1, R2, then here you are going to add R1 and R2 and the result is stored in register R1. That means one of the register will lose its content. One of the register will lose its original content. That is the disadvantage. In order to avoid this one, you can take 3 register. It doesn't mean that you are going to add 3 register at a time. Because it will not allow you to add 3 registers. For example, see, why it will not allow you to add 3 registers? For example, if you add 9 plus 9, then you know it is 18. That is, sum is 8 and carry is 1. If you add 9 plus 9, biggest 2 digit number, then 9 plus 9, 18. 1 is carry. 9 plus 9 is 18. And 9 and 1 is carry. But suppose if you add 9 plus 9 plus 9, then it is 27. Sum is 7 and carry is 2. This is fine on the book, but it is fine on the book and other language, other like programming language like C and other languages, but not in assembly language. Because in assembly language, when you add 2 numbers, the carry should be either 1 or 0. It cannot be 2. That's why if you write add R1, R2, R3, it doesn't mean that you are going to add all 3 registers. You are doing the addition of R2 plus R3 and result is stored in R1. That is the meaning of this one. So back to the diagram. So here one operation. So in this instruction, let us take this instruction, add R0 and R1 and R2. So two operands comes from R1 and R2, and that will be added in arithmetic and logic unit, and the result will be stored once again in R0. In this case, it is R0 depending on the instruction. So same thing will be followed for this one, logic operation, like logic operation, arithmetic operations, and logic operations like AND or whatever may be. So same will be followed for this one. So this is how it works. Now we'll move to the next one more functional block diagram, that is barrel shifter. What is a barrel shifter? So according to ARM arithmetic, ARM official document, the shifter, this shifter is considered as a barrel shifter. But actually, if you take all modern shifter are barrel shifter, all modern shifters are a barrel shifter. So all the modern shifters are barrel shifter. So don't confuse with the word barrel, because it is nothing but just a shifter. That means it can do multiple shift operations in one clock cycle. That is a barrel shifter. Now you can ask here why barrel shifter is used. So when you talk about shifter are used with the scaling operation. That means scaling operation. That means let me write here. Like if you take 0010, what is the value of this number? That is 8421. This is 2. If I left shift it, then if I left shift this number, this becomes 4. If I right shift this number, this becomes 2. That means when you left shift, you can upgrade the number or downgrade the number depending on the left shift or right shift. That is, you can see here, when you left shift, the number becomes 4. When you right shift, the number becomes 2. Similarly, we'll take one more example here. If you left shift this number, right shift this number, this becomes, this value is 8. This becomes 4. That is, division will take place. 8 by 2, division, 4, division. Division will take place. When you right shift this number, so let me right shift this number, then this becomes 16. Multiplication will take place. So when you left shift, multiplication will take place. When you right shift, division will take place. That is the main job of the shifter. So shifters are used in a scaling operation, downscale and upscale operation. You will come to know later. So here for the ALU, two operands are given, one directly, other through shifter. One is directly, the other through shifter, to improve the performance of the system, and output of the ALU is stored in one of the register. Now student, after completing barrel shifter, I will move to MAC. What is this MAC? So how it works, we'll see. Now the next concept is multiply and accumulate. What do you mean by multiply and accumulate? So multiply and accumulate, this functional unit is used to improve the performance. In fact, ALU also do the multiplication. But why we need multiply and accumulate? Multiply and accumulate is needed when you do the multiplication of large to large number. For example, suppose if I want to add two very big large numbers like 1 what we know from our schooling. So each step, multiplier is multiplied by multiplicand, and partial result will be stored at each stage. And finally, at the end, all these partial results are summed up. So if you take this one, this is fine with respect to paper, but in the computer, when the computer processes these two numbers, now the question comes, where will you store this partial sum. Where will you store this partial sum? Because if you multiply 264 digit number, very big 264 digit number, there will be 64 partial sums are there, and to store this 64 partial sums, you need 64 register for this purpose. So in order to avoid this one, we are taking one big register. We are taking one big register, and initially we will initialize that register with zero, and as soon as we get that partial product, we will add this register with that partial product. That is called as multiply and accumulate. Multiply and accumulate. That is called as multiply and accumulate. So let me take you to the diagram. Multiply and accumulate, MAC. So what is the use of this one? The use of this one is it will allow you to free up for the unnecessary use of registers, and it will store all sum of all the partial products in one register. That is the use of MAC. Later, when you use the instruction like MUL R1, R2 into R3, then R2 and R3 are multiplied and the results are stored in R1. You will come to know more about MAC when you use the instruction MUL. So now we will move to the next section, that is address register. What is the use of address register? We know what is the use of address registers. So address registers are used in base and indexing method. That is, suppose you have an array of 2000. The starting address of the array, let us take like 2000, and you want to access the array consecutively from 2000 to next 10 numbers. That time we are using two registers. One is like say R1 to store the starting address of the array. Other one is used to store the index. So that here you can see ALU first time generate the address like 2000 plus 1, and this will store the address in address register 2000 plus 1. For the next consecutive location, this address is incremented directly by using incrementer without using the use of ALU. First ALU will generate address, the next onwards ALU is freed up, and address will be automatically incremented by the incrementer instead of using ALU. So that is the use of address register and incrementer. So students, with this I have covered the core model or architecture of ARM7. I have explained what is the use of I have started with the instruction decoder, sign extend. I have explained what is register file, what is ALU function, what is barrel shifter, what is multiply and accumulate, what is address register, what is incrementer, all those things. So with this I will wind up this video. Thank you.